And before we go, even the fashion industry is joining the cause for the environment. Renowned British fashion designer Stella McCartney wants laws put in place to limit the damage the industry causes to the climate and the environment. McCartney is attending the COP28 in Dubai to speak to policymakers with the aim of coming up with laws to limit the fashion industry's harmful impacts. The clothing and footwear industry is responsible for up to 10% of greenhouse gas emissions, which is more than shipping and international flights combined. McCartney made the pitch at a showcase of fashion products that featured faux leather and fur, as well as coat made from recycled plastic sourced from oil-based clothing. Luxury residences in the Philippine capital of Manila logging the fastest growing price globally. That's according to real estate consultancy firm Santos Knight Frank. The report said the price growth of Manila's prime residences hit 21.2% over the past 12 months and at 19% in just the last 6 months. Those figures topping those of luxury homes in Dubai, Shanghai, Mumbai, and Madrid. Santos Knight Frank chairman Rick Santos says pent-up demand for prime properties, the return of the residential leasing market, and the tight supply of developments have contributed to the price appreciation. The Global Tourism Business Association seeing international arrivals doubling next year. That's the hope. That's as long as government continues its efforts to boost the sector, according to the group. The Philippines last month already breached its conservative full-year 2023 target of 4.8 million international arrivals. The group's president, Michelle Taylan, tells ANC's Market Edge infrastructure improvements, especially the rehabilitation of Manila's international airport, should be prioritized.
With the numerous progress and developments that we have made this 2023, I can see that we expect a very fruitful tourism industry by 2024, and it is expected that hopefully the pandemic will end truly, and the whole world will be expected to recover. Tourism will continue to flourish, of course, by building partnerships to different stakeholders. And of course, we also expect that there will be some improvements in our tourism infrastructure.
Philippine transportation officials eye implementing the proposed fare increase in the Metro Rail transit by the end of the first quarter of next year. Our correspondent, Andrea Taguines, now joins us on the line for more on that story. Andy, hi.
Good afternoon, Mimi. An increase in the fare for the MRT3 could be implemented by the end of March or the beginning of April next year. That's according to MRT3 OIC General Manager, Department of Transportation Assistant Secretary Georgette Aquino. In a press conference a while ago, Aquino said they will be refiling this week their petition for a fare hike after their initial request last January was denied by regulators. The management of MRT3 is seeking an additional 2 peso and 29 centavo increase for the boarding fee and a 21 centavo increase per kilometer. If approved, the minimum fare will go up to 16 pesos from the current 13 pesos, while an end-to-end trip from North Avenue Station to Taft Avenue Station would go up to 34 pesos from the current 28 pesos. Aquino said that despite seeing the MRT3's ridership and revenue rise during the first 10 months of the year, it still faces a multi-billion dollar deficit when taking into account the train's operating and maintenance expenses. So far, Aquino said they have already received feedback from the Land Transportation Franchising and Regulatory Board, as well as the National Economic and Development Authority. According to Aquino, the LTFRB noted that even with the proposed fare hike, the MRT3 fare would still be cheaper than other modes of public transportation like city buses, air-conditioned city buses, and air-conditioned modern jeepneys. As for the NEDA, it does not see any significant impact on inflation. The national government is, the NEDA also noted that this would lessen the pressure, lessen the need for the national government to give subsidies to the MRT3, because currently the national government is subsidizing a significant portion of MRT fares, like about 41 pesos for every passenger going on an end-to-end ride. Aquino said that with the fare increase, the government will be able to hopefully reallocate more resources to other programs and projects that could benefit more people beyond Metro Manila. Meanwhile, the MRT3 management assured commuters that there are safety and security protocols in place for their protection in light of the recent bombing in Marawi. Aquino said that they are prepared to further tighten protocols should they see fit. Mimi?
All right. Thank you very much for that update. Andrea Taguines joining us on the line. Double Dragon's Dragonite Mall in Divisoria, Manila, hitting a three-year high customer foot traffic over the weekend. Clearly cashing in on the holiday rush, Double Dragon says the mall recorded over 67,000 customers, and it expects this to further increase as Christmas nears. The six-story Dragonite Mall is located within the bustling shopping area of Divisoria. By next year, Double Dragon expects foot traffic to exceed 200,000 with the anticipated completion of the Malolos-Tutuban rail project. Let's now check on some corporate stories making news this day. Mega World partners with subsidiary SunTrust Properties to develop its 31st township development. It is allocating 7 billion pesos to develop a lifestyle estate in Puerto Princesa City, Palawan in the next 5 years. It will feature condominium projects, hotels, as well as commercial retail developments. Meanwhile, Manila Water says it has suspended its excavation activities within Metro Manila. This move in compliance with the government's order to temporarily suspend major roadworks in the capital region to alleviate heavier than usual traffic during the holiday season. The water concessionaire assured its customers that its service will remain available 24/7. And finally, Union Bank of the Philippines successfully raised 18 billion pesos for its dual tranche offering. This is the largest bond issuance by the bank from its 50 billion peso bonds program. The 1.5-year Series F bonds due 2025 raised a total of 10.3 billion pesos carrying an interest rate of about 6.6% per annum, while the 3-year Series G bonds due 2026 raised a total of 7.8 billion pesos carrying an interest rate of around 6.7% per annum.